Does the city of Calgary have a spending problem? Many residential and business taxpayers would say yes. Property taxes for small business have gone up substantially. And while city council has promised to make cuts in order to ease the tax burden, will it be enough? This is where we bring in Danielle Smith from Global News Radio 770 CHQR to continue this conversation. It's an ongoing conversation, Danielle, and I know you are touching base with an economics professor today.
Yes, Moshe Lander. He's a sessional who's in Alberta for the summer and an expert in the area of municipal finance. And so I want to talk to him about it because people are feeling very frustrated that, first of all, council doesn't want to take any lead in directing administration on where to find cuts. So they leave it to administration to do. And then what does administration come back with? Oh, well, we need to cut police and fire, the two services that I could probably safely say most people would say don't cut there. There's lots of other places that they would be able to find savings. So that's, I think, the source of frustration, is trying to understand what the motivation is here. It's kind of inconceivable when you think about it, that the municipal government has a $4 billion budget, and to ask them to cut and find $60 million worth of savings seems to be such an impossible task without cutting into the front line. So there's obviously some dynamic that is happening there that doesn't make sense. You can't continue to see the kind of increases that Calgary has seen year after year after year, even through the downturn in the economy, and then have the administration turn around and say that it's impossible to find any cuts in a meaningful way. And we do segments all the time where people are phoning in their suggestions. One of the ones that just sticks in my mind is there were three people who were using the weed whackers to cut grass at a dog park. Now, is that really the highest priority use of our lawn care personnel? Or maybe you could do it with two people, or maybe you could do it with one person. Like there seems to me a whole bunch of low-hanging fruit nobody is even looking at. And we're going to see if Moshe Lander has some advice for us on where it is the city should be looking.
And if he does, it'd be interesting to hear what it is for sure. Danielle, thanks for this.
Yeah, my pleasure.
You can listen to Danielle's show on Global News Radio starting at 9:30 this morning.